Hey, what's going on YouTube? It's Young Goku Beats, and today I'm going to be showing you guys how to connect your MIDI into your FL Studio. Now, first things first, make sure that it is plugged into your computer. USB port, of course. We're going to go to Options. Then we're going to go to MIDI Settings. First thing you would like to do is rescan your MIDI device. And you would like to go to the keyboard, whatever, you know, the hardware port. You click on it. Make sure that it's enabled. Mine's is already enabled, but you make sure that it's enabled. You click on that, and the controller type is going to be generic controller unless you have one of these brands, but most likely it's going to be the generic controller. Yeah, it's pretty much set right there, and as you can see, you can hear the kick I'm using on the keyboard, the MIDI controller, that is. This is perfect. It's great. It makes the process go much quicker when you're making beats. Where do I start, you guys? It's pretty cool. It's pretty cool. You have to excuse me, you guys. I'm pretty much excited today. I had some pretty good news. You know, you can basically record your sounds into the playlist. Now, this is what you want to do. This is what I do. You know, you can just name the pattern, whatever. I usually go up to 20, you know, that's what we're gonna do. You click on this light, you know, this is the kick, and, you know, just click on your playlist, make sure it's on the song, and you can record. Now, to record in the playlist, make sure you right-click on the record button, and you click on score. And automation, you can click on all three, it doesn't matter, just make sure you got score clicked. Some people are good at, you know, recording sounds without the metronome, but I highly prefer it because you don't want to be off beat. So I don't like my BPMs at 140. I'm going to turn it down to 75. Precisely. So we're gonna do this little kick rhythm. I'm gonna press record. Here we go. See, we have a problem, you guys. Now, I know that a lot of you guys are going to, you know, wonder why is this latency problem. Oops, excuse me, latency. Well, basically, you know, when you start the keyboard, it's like a delay when you press the button. So what are we going to do? We're going to go to Options. And we're going to go to Audio. And right here, where it says Primary Sound Driver, you're going to click on that. And you're going to go to ACO for All Version 2. Now, I can't click on it right now because it will knock the, you know, the sound off. You know, I'm recording the screen. Now, you're going to click on that. And when you do, it's going to have, you know, everything's going to be on key, like the time. You're going to press the time, you know, I mean, they're going to press the keyboard and everything is going to be on time. You can make your beats, you know, to your, you know, to whatever, you know, if you're making beats for porn, recording artists, TV, for your own enjoyment. You got the world in your hands. So when you do the keys, it won't be offbeat. It won't be late, a delay. You just go in and boom, you know, you just make your sound. I'm going to be making more videos. If you guys have any questions, just hit me up. Subscribe, like the video. If you don't, that's pretty awesome. It's been great. It's been real. Visit my site, www.younggokubeats.com. The link will be in the description. I would like to thank you guys for taking your time out to learn this. Have a blessed day, and I will talk to you guys later. Ciao.